I come inside.
Yesterday, he was the fastest man on the warm-up this morning. Don't know if he made a slight mistake or not, because he has dropped back as opposed to Bruno pulling away, because Bruno was a little bit ahead of Dominguez about two laps earlier. But Junqueira is very quick around Long Beach. Bourdais has even said he thinks he's quicker than he is. Can you imagine Bourdais admitting that Junqueira might be quicker than he is around this particular street circuit here at Long Beach that I've never seen look as good?
Newfound confidence after a championship a year ago. Everyone was always concerned about the green flag, the start of the run to turn one at Long Beach. Let's take you back a couple of moments and show you what happened when the green came out as we watch Tracy here chasing down, trying to chase down Bruno Junqueira.
Oh, Tracy locks up a wheel, and is that what made him go wide a little bit? That was some of the action earlier on. That was Tagliani going down inside Timo Glock.
That was lap two, I believe, when we had some movement down into turn one. The start was very clean. Now, Champ Car World Series officials have changed their approach a little this year, Derek. They are not going to wave off a start unless it's extremely ragged, and Tracy got the drop on Junqueira.
The new man to call those signals is Tony Cotman. He is very experienced New Zealander. He said he does not want these races to be won or lost through the officials. He's going to let it sort itself out as much on the racetrack as possible. And we had a very clean start to the start of the season.
Paul Tracy was our Bridgestone Pole Award winner earlier this weekend. Knocked off a new lap record here at Long Beach on Saturday. Track record for Tracy, 1:07.485. That's nearly 105 miles an hour. He collects the Bridgestone Pole Award in the first race of the year.
I believe Paul Tracy did make a mistake, which it allowed Junqueira to go by. A reason I can back that up, he just set the fastest lap of the race at 1:10.4, which is 0.3 seconds faster than Bruno Junqueira. This could give us a real street fight here, because catching a driver on a street circuit is one thing. Having the room to try and force your way by is something completely different.
And will Paul Tracy be patient enough? A year ago, Derek, we saw him, frankly, make some mistakes when the car wasn't as good, perhaps, as he was. He tried to overcompensate, I think, sometimes.
I don't know. Tracy and patience, those two words don't really go together. You don't just associate him with being patient.
Tracy in second spot. Junqueira is the leader. Bruno in that two car. Car from the Newman Haas stables, the Pacific Air machine. He's been the runner-up in the Champ Car World Series standings the last three seasons. Two victories a year ago. Badly wants a title here in 2005.
Frustration for Bruno there on the left side. Look at Dominguez, middle of your picture right there. Do you know what the funny thing about this? Mario Dominguez arrived with his helmet bag. First thing he had to do on Thursday, introduce himself to his team. Hello, I'm Mario. I'm your driver. He had never met any of the guys before.
Many unique perspectives here in Long Beach. Calvin Fish has one of them.
One of the great characteristics of Champ Car racing is the diversity of the race circuits that they run on. They run on ovals, they run on road courses, and of course they run here on the streets. And here in the grandstands this weekend, close to 200,000 people have jammed these to do one thing, and that's to watch these guys, some of the best race car drivers in the world. John Kira, Tracy, Dominguez, Bourdais, Wilson. These guys there gravelly with up to 800 horsepower coming off this hip on, torturing those Bridgestone tires up for 180 miles an hour. There's no traction control. This is pure racing, pure adrenaline. It's the Long Beach Grand Prix.
Wow. Gavin, I'm sure you weren't standing on the racetrack, but that looked like you were standing right on the racetrack as those boys whizzed by.
Could have reached out and given someone a high five on the way by from his vantage point down there. John Kira continues to lead. We've put seven laps of 81 on the scoreboard here at the Grand Prix of Long Beach. We are getting ready for quite a battle. Tracy second, Dominguez and Bourdais, and we have a problem on the racetrack. One car is off.
On the wing is off.
Yep, looks as though it might be. It's one of the MyJack cars.
Nelson Philippe. Nelson, I mean, he's well buried. This is the MyJack Conquest. See the wing gone completely off the stays. This is one of our 18-year-old drivers, teammate to Andrew Ranger.
Full course caution for the first time today on lap 7. We've got another look at it for you.
Okay, in the brake zone. Oh, he gets it. Oh, his teammate comes down the inside. Whoa!
That's young Andrew Ranger, also 18, and a rookie in the yellow MyJack car.
Wow, talk about getting dumped into the boonies by your brother. Man, I can't believe he did that. And Ranger almost took himself off the road.
Now, did Nelson Philippe just not give him enough room there, Derek, or did Ranger go someplace where he shouldn't have gone?
No, Ranger went someplace he shouldn't have stuck his nose. Have a look here. In fact, Nelson Philippe, watch him right here. You see him begin to wiggle slightly in the brake zone, but Ranger has his mind made up. I'm going down the inside, going down the inside. Now I can't stop, can't stop. My teammate turns in. Oh, no. Hope the team owner isn't watching. How can I blame somebody else? Oh, I'm going to get sideways myself. Boom. He's in the wall. I escape. Man, how am I going to make an excuse about this?
Well, it looks like they're going to refire Nelson Philippe's number 34 MyJack Conquest machine. He perhaps can drive it around the pit road. They can put the wing back on and get it back in competition. We will see. Meantime, John Kira leads Tracy. You're watching Champ Car on NBC. Of course, Jan Beekes, Calvin Fish, a couple of cars deciding to head in early. We knew Philippe would come in to get the wing replaced.
Okay, but here's what's going on. The pit windows that we've had for the last couple of seasons are now gone. So the people who are on the back half of the grid will take a chance and dive in. They go out of sequence, but they are hoping now that the yellow flags will work in their favor as they make early pit stops.
Jimmy Vassar among those on pit road. Vassar not happy with his car. He was 15th last time by in the Gulf Coast car. We saw Marcus Marshall in the Aussie Vineyards number 5 from Derek Walker's team.
And Derek Walker is one of the strategic masterminds of racing. So he is going to use a philosophy that he used in Australia last year with David Besnar to get his man leapfrog up the front using track position. Yeah.
Nelson Philippe has brought his race car on the racetrack. There is a new rule this year. You may not be on the racetrack if you do not have a set of front and rear wings. In the past, sometimes people would kind of limp around the racetrack until the team had an opportunity to have a rear wing ready. In this case, you may not go back on the racetrack until they fully repair Nelson Philippe's machine.
Still working on the MyJack Conquest car. New sponsorship on that 34 car about to be announced when we get to Monterrey, Mexico in the month of May. Field single file starting to pick up the pace, heading to the backstretch, looking for a restart. 9 of 81 laps are complete. We'll go green on lap number 10. John Kira leading Tracy, Dominguez and Bourdais. And Derek, looked like Tracy was starting to reel John Kira back in right before the caution.
Made a comment that Tracy had a faster lap than John Kira. John Kira then came right back faster than Paul Tracy. So right now, from what we see lap times, John Kira appears to be able to match Tracy's speed. And even if you get close to Tracy's, oh, look at that, concertina. If you get close to him, it's just hard to pass when you're in the concrete confines here at Long Beach.
Bourdais is fourth in line in the McDonald's number one, the defending series champion. Justin Wilson, second-year driver, Formula One veteran from Britain, fifth in that red and white number 9. Ready for a restart at Long Beach.
They go down to first gear. They go all the way up to 7 forward gears and blast this long straight. This was almost 184 miles an hour during qualifying on the board with Bourdais. That is Dominguez right beside him, right in front of him.
Dominguez up ahead there, third in the seven for the Indec Forsyth team. Did Tracy get around? He did. Paul Tracy grabbed the lead from Bruno Junqueira on that restart. So Tracy boldly takes the point back once again as we go green in Long Beach.
The bravery of the man on somewhat cold tires. Paul Tracy, not even one lap into this restart, and he managed to pull a move on Bruno Junqueira, and he's only three or four corners into this first lap when he makes the move.
Paul Tracy has four Long Beach Grand Prix victories, including the last two wins. He would love to make it a hat trick on the streets of Long Beach today. Got another look for you at how Tracy retook the lead moments ago as we watch cars come down the backstretch. This is for the restart.
Oh, with the brakes on, man, into the first corner, and Tracy did what he did to Bourdais last season, or last year. Doesn't matter. Tracy got down the inside and took the apex line, forces Junqueira's hand. Man, I'm surprised Bruno allowed him so much room inside for Tracy to make that move. But opportunistic move for Paul Tracy.
Still early, 11 laps complete, 70 to go, a lot of time left. Junqueira, though, is a guy who seems to like to be out in front, as does Tracy. He doesn't like to run second.
So all these boys now have not made a pit stop, so they're all probably going to look at each other to see when the leader goes in and potentially follow him. A brown lap 28 to 31 is about the pit stop time. Calvin?
Here with the general manager for Forsyth Racing, Neil Mick. Right, Neil, it looked like Paul was ready to get back in the lead. Did he use the push-to-pass button there?
Yeah, we used about 10 seconds of push-to-pass on that restart. We had a bit of a glitch earlier there on about lap 3 or 4 when we accidentally hit the pit lane cruise button and consequently got behind Junqueira. But we're back in the lead now, so we'll see what we can do with it.
Looks like you guys have regrouped over the off-season, ready for 05.
The whole team's worked very hard, drivers included, to try and do the best job that we can. So we're going to take it to them.
All right, Paul Tracy looking for win number 5 here on the streets of Long Beach.
Now, Forsyth Championship Racing right now taking it to them, first and third. And it has to upset or certainly not please a team like Jerry Forsyth's squad. Newman Haas has been the dominant team the last couple of years.
Yes, they have, but on the streets of Long Beach, you come armed with a Paul Tracy. With a man who knows how to use push to pass. How do you do that? Actually, push to pass this year is called officially the Cosworth.
Power to pass.
Power to pass.
A little different name for a device that was invented by Cosworth and by Champ Car Visions last year, and it added a lot to the show. It gave drivers an opportunity to have a little extra, 50 extra horsepower, General.
50 horsepower, taking the power from 750 all the way to 800 horsepower, and they used them very well with Tracy at the end of that brake zone. The McDonald's car with Bourdais, a lot of suspension movement in that car. You don't often see that these days, but Bourdais now, that's Justin Wilson. You see him right behind him. Wilson has gone very well all weekend long here. Quicker than his teammate, A.J. Allmendinger, who's running 11th, but Wilson is a threat to win one of these races pretty soon.
Justin was very good last year in the relatively underfunded MyJack Conquest team. He's moved to Roseport this year, and he has been the leading driver as we watch several of the cars work down the front straightaway here. There's A.J. Allmendinger in that number 10, the white and yellow Roseport machine with Beijing 06 on that side by this weekend. The series will be going to China for a race for the first ever time come next season. New feature for you in 2005, behind the wheel. We're going to meet these Champ Car stars up close and personal. A.J. Allmendinger is the first driver that we will show you and help you learn more about this season. Allmendinger's favorite movie, Old School. He's got a Toyota Tundra at home. Listens to Usher on his CD player. Says Lance Armstrong is his favorite athlete. And we'll see and hear a lot more of A.J. Allmendinger today and throughout the 2005 Champ Car World Series season.
See him now chasing Ryan Hunter-Reay. Ryan Hunter-Reay, another part of the change this year. Moved over to Rocket Sports. Lost most of Friday's practice session with fuel problems, but the leaders are beginning to settle in. Dominguez having a good run here. One of the questions great people talked about earlier is all these new young guys in the Champ Car Racing. Very little physical testing. This physically is one of the most difficult racetracks to survive the full length of the race. That will be interesting in the last 20 laps.
Bruno Junqueira second, chasing Paul Tracy through the streets of Long Beach. More Champ Car coming up. Champions of Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. Cristiano D'Amata returning this season after 2 years for Toyota in Formula One. D'Amata eighth now. He's with the PKV team, the Bell Micro 21 car. Got his helmet camera today, and we'll take a look through his eyes, through his viewpoint. But D'Amata trying to fight that race car and hustle it toward the front. Hey, coming up on Wednesday, a premiere of Revelations for you on NBC. It's a brand new miniseries event starring Bill Pullman. He's a Harvard-trained doctor whose world of science will be put to the test. At the end of days of lives, the ultimate battle of good and evil is joined. Revelations, Wednesday night at 9, 8 Central, only on NBC. With Derek Daly, I'm Rick Benjamin. Welcome to the streets of Long Beach. Great to have you with us. The 31st Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach. Up front, it's Paul Tracy, who was on the pole. Gave up the lead early. We heard Neil Micklewright say, hit the wrong button in the cockpit. Lost the lead to Junqueira.
Yeah, pit lane speed limiter, which basically cuts the power of the engine. Bruno goes by. He gets his act together. Pushes the cost button, which is like the NOS button, spelled with a C, Cosworth. Cost button, got 50 extra horsepower to pull ahead of Junqueira in a great braking move. Yeah?
Well, Derek, you asked a question. Well, what about Bruno Junqueira? Did he press the Cosworth power to pass button? I checked with the Newman Haas team. The answer is no. I said, very simple. Why wasn't he on the button? He said, well, we're saving it for later. But I think the real answer is it's very easy as a driver to know to press the button offensively, but it's much different to remember to do it defensively. I don't think he expected Paul Tracy to make that move. Now they do have more power to pass for later in the race. Unfortunately, it may be a little too little, too late.
Very good point, Jan, because that was a push. He should have used it as a push not to pass, but to keep him ahead of Tracy. Because of what we said earlier on, even if he is quicker, it is so difficult to make a pass at racing speeds when you have to be so accurate between these concrete walls.
Now, one of the things, if you're not familiar with the Champ Car World Series and the power to pass button that was introduced last year, the drivers get 60 seconds of that extra 50 horsepower, Derek, and using it wisely, knowing when to go to the button and when to save some, that's a key part of the strategy here.
And of course, what happened was most people understood you better use it right off the start line on the run to the first corner, or you can get left behind. Tracy used it last year to perfection to put himself into the lead and pretty much gave himself an advantage that he was never to lose.
Back to Cristiano D'Amata, our Lucas Oil helmet cam. Let's listen, a little talk about strategy. A little earlier, Cristiano D'Amata on the radio with his crew chief and team manager, Steve Krisiloff.
If you can get a little better mileage, we can go one more extra lap. One seven four.
Actually, that is Jim McGee, the new general manager of that team. So see the Bell microcar there with D'Amata right ahead of Ronnie Bremner. He's asking him if he can just get the speed without using all the gas, get one more lap with the car nice and light with hot tires before he makes the fuel stop, that it could give him an advantage. Basically, that car does not handle very well this weekend, and it's been a struggle for Cristiano, yeah?
When you talk about, you hear on the radio, 174, that's their target number for fuel economy. We're hearing it up and down pit road, 1.81 we've heard. What happens is the teams call their driver, and they have a readout on the dash as to their average mile per gallon. When they cross the start-finish line, when they call you and say 1.74, your job is to drive as fast as you can, as long as you don't go under that number, so you can make an extra lap.
Fuel economy important here, even though it's only a 160-mile race.
Those of you at home who have a regular road car, you get 19 or 20 miles per gallon, and you complain, think about if you owned an IndyCar. get 1.8 miles to the gallon, and they're trying to get 1.74 miles to the gallon. Of course, it is methanol, it is alcohol, but that they drink fuel at a ferocious rate in these cars.
Watching the battle for the lead, Tracy is your leader, Junqueira second, Dominguez third, maybe the most impressive and the leading rookie so far. This is Timo Glock from Germany in car number 8, the Rocket Sports car, but it's sponsored by Deutsche Post, a whole new livery on that car. Calvin Fish with more.
Well, certainly he's the most impressive of this new batch of rookies, and Paul Genelozzi, you got to be happy with the performance of Timo, but right now you're looking at the lap times. Is there a problem with the car?
Well, I think what happened, as a rookie, we started him on the option tire, the red tire. There were stickers. You usually get a little more pressure climb that caused the car to be loose. He's concerned he had a flat tire. That means he's thinking about it.
Certainly qualified very well. I know in Tessin he was sensational. You're expecting a lot from him this year, Paul.
Well, we're hoping. You know, Rocket Sports has worked hard to have two great drivers in between Ryan and Timo. We think we've got that. Right now, Timo's in front. We'll be all right.
Good luck, mate.
Thanks, guys.
Timo Glock in sixth.
Sponsored by Deutsche Post, which is basically the German post office, they have a speed academy to develop their young driver. This is the product. F1, not a position for him right now, comes over here. He's only 23 years of age, making a great name for himself. And they're waving the flag for Germany as an ambassador for that country around the world because they have supported his career. Come on, America.
Ryan Hunter Ray, one of the Americans in the field, the other Rocket Sports driver in 10th. We'll be back with more coverage of Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford after these messages. And we'll join Al Trotwood for an ADT Security NBC Sports update. Back with more of the Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach on NBC Sports. I'm Rick Benjamin, Derek Daly alongside. We're 25 laps in. Derek, Paul Tracy has been the dominant force. Bruno Junqueira can't stay with him. The gap 3.3 seconds as they head to turn one.
Tracy and Junqueira have exactly the same to a thousandth of a second fast laps in this race. Believe it or not, Wilson is the fastest man on the racetrack on the last particular lap. Jan Beekes.
And we're getting calls from the cars, in particular from the Newman Haas camp, and you're looking at your second place for Bruno Junqueira, says the tires are going away. Now what that means is they've started on the reds, as you call them, Derek, and we've heard from a lot of different drivers that they're starting to lose adhesion. The track is getting slippery on the reds. Many of them are calling to the pits and say, the next pit stop, I want the blacks or the standard Bridgestones.
Which is a regulation. You must use at least for one of your stints, the blacks and the reds, blacks being a bit slower. I don't see Tracy slowing down. Well, Tracy did a 10.6, 1 minute 10.6 on his last lap. Bruno did a 10.3, a little bit faster. Dominguez was actually the fastest man on that last lap. So there, it's a bit cat and mouse right now. One's fast one lap, another guy's fast the next lap. But I don't see a big drop-off for Junqueira.
No,
don't see it.
Checking the splits last time around, Junqueira picked up half a second on Tracy, so he's got the whip out here. Tracy's slowing down a little bit, it appears, although he had a substantial lead.
We expect pit stops to be around 28 to 30 laps.
One of the first cars in, Timo Glock headed to pit road, running seventh for the Rocket Sports team. Calvin Fish.
Well, he was one of those drivers struggling on the red side. They've gone to the standard setup, waiting on fuel. No chassis adjustment. Very impressive indeed by the Rocket Sport team.
David Watson is his engineer. Another move to that team. I would say this team is just absolutely thrilled with his performance this weekend here. New culture, new racing series, new racing cars, and he ran that well.
As we watch Tracy, the former series champ, leading here, 26 laps on the board. That seems like an early stop, Derek.
Yes.
Every team say 28, maybe 30 laps before stop.
And that's a major key, because now here's the disadvantage to Glock. He's now on cold tires. Worst of all, he's on a full tank of gas, and Tracy is not going to be too far behind him here. His light fuel, hot tires, just smoking him by probably a second and a half or 2 seconds a lap. So that was very costly for Timo Glock to make that early pit stop.
One of the signature scenes here in Long Beach. You got a glimpse of Tracy going by the fountain curves, turns 2, 3, and 4 here on the streets of Long Beach. So Paul Tracy grabbed the lead at the drop of the green earlier, made an error, hit the wrong button on the steering wheel, hit the pit road speed limiter, lost the lead to Junqueira, got it right back. He's been out front ever since.
For those of you who are curious as to what all those tire tracks are across that piece of road, there is more zigzag figure eight tire tracks all over this racetrack, because over the last 2 days we've had phenomenal drifting exhibitions. For those of you who have never seen drifting, it just had people just shouting and screaming here in support of cars that basically look out of control, fully in control. Look at this.
He's about to be lapped. Timo Glock, first car to pit road. That's the yellow and red Rocket Sports number eight. Here comes the Indec Forsythe 3 of leader Paul Tracy, about to drop him a lap down.
Yeah, and there's the problem. This is such a competitive series. If you come out of step with the leaders and make early pit stops, it is hugely costly in time. Not what you stop, not the time you spend on the pit road, but now the time you spend on full tanks when a leader like Tracy is just flying with a lightweight car compared to your truck.
Checking the lap times last time around, Bruno Junqueira took another 10th off Tracy's lead, now 2.4 seconds. So Junqueira methodically trying to chop that lead down, perhaps get a break on pit road and get an opportunity to challenge for the lead here.
And now the key is now, look at Tracy sawing away at the wheel there to try and stay ahead of Bruno. The rule on lapped cars is you will be told over the radio, be careful, the leader's going to pass you. You will then be warned with a flag. If you still do not move over to let the leader go by, you will be given a stop and go.
Now, some philosophers in the paddock were saying that might give guys a license to block a couple of times before getting the penalty.
Tracy will probably end up coming in. It's right now. He's in.
Gavin Fish.
Tracy makes his way down pit lane. Neil Micklewright guiding him in. We expect a slight front tire pressure change low going to the standard tires.
Doing good. That's good on the mark. Junqueira just going in, so he went as far as he did. I want you to reset your fuel meter and start getting ready. Get ready, get ready. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Go, 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 go. Watch the pit lane. Watch the speed.
Job done once again.
While that was happening, Calvin, we had a stop also for Bruno Junqueira. No changes on the car, 11.5 seconds. It looked like they tried to be a little quicker on pit road. I thought maybe a short fill to try and pass Paul Tracy. That wasn't the case. The main reason, they wanted the black sidewalled Bridgestones.
So the cars that were in the lead coming out now, they've made green flag pit stops. No more mandatory windows. Stop when you need to here in the Champ Car World Series.
Dominguez and Bourdais now have an advantage. They can go a second a lap faster, than at least maybe 2 seconds a lap faster than a Tracy or a Junqueira, because they've stayed out longer. I don't know how long they can stay out. And also Tracy now and Junqueira are right in the middle of a freeway traffic jam that will not be to their advantage. Okay, Dominguez peels off. Bourdais now has a huge advantage.
And one of the advantages Newman Haas showed us last year, superior fuel economy in many cases. Dominguez in, Calvin.
We expect no chassis adjustment here. We'll be standard tires. That's the norm. They're going to be standards for the middle. And then they'll go to the rest for the final step. Slight right wing change, bit more right wing, half a turn of wing, waiting on fuel. Dominguez away. Very impressive indeed. This man never met his team till Thursday. What a performance. Qualifying third and running at the front of the pack, Rick.
Sebastian Bourdais takes over the point in the McDonald's number one. Series champion in 2004. 7 wins in 14 starts. Still on the Bridgestone Red Potenzas, Derek Daly. He's getting great mileage and his tires haven't given up as much yet.
Okay, this is
Oh, one car around. Yeah. One car around at the head of the backstretch. It might have been Del Monte in that 41 again, and it is. Second time today that the new Jensen Motorsport entry, the Konica Minolta 41, has gone around, and we'll have at least a local yellow.
Tony Kottmann did tell us he was going to try and clean up as many as he could under local yellow. So he's got to get him turned around and get it fired, or he's going to be forced to go full course yellow as Bourdais comes in.
Race leader heading to pit road, coming your way, Andikas.
Option stuff going on, full load of fuel, Brian. Right on the mark. Good stop here, guys.
Now, of course, the question is, did he get in before the pits were closed? That is obviously going to be ultra important for Bourdais. The stewards were being very careful.
Wait a minute, Steph. They're finishing.
That was 11-2, and we could see the fuel in the vent hose, meaning that that car is absolutely full, and it appears as though he did get in before they closed the pits. The crew is celebrating. That's what they wanted.
They caught it exactly right, Jan, because they just threw the full course yellow, just as we learned from the new director of operations for Champ Car, Tony Kottmann. They had a local yellow out there. They've just gone full course.
Oh, there's the lead. Tracy just manages to catch the lead. almost pulled it off. He stayed out a long time, ran longer than Tracy on a light fuel load. The question was, could he make the move and get the track position? We just caught a great picture there of Tracy just managing to hang on to the lead.
Now, there was a full course yellow out. Did Tracy pass under the caution? We shall see. While Tracy has nipped in front of Sebastian Bourdais for now, Jimmy Vassar being shown in second spot. Remember, Vassar stopped very early during the first full course yellow here today. 31 of 81 laps are complete on the streets of Long Beach. We'll be back with more of the Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford after these messages and a word from our local NBC station.
Is on his left, Tracy's right. Tracy just about pulls it off to perfection. On board now with Sebastian Bourdais. He knows Tracy's coming down the straight. He's going as fast as he can to try and turn to the apex before Paul gets there. He now wants to do it. Oh, there's Tracy appears. He says, whoa. But the big advantage for Bourdais was it was yellow, and nobody on hot tires could run him down and pass him.
So he gained some ground by pitting before pit road was closed. Well, Sebastian Bourdais didn't win the pole here this weekend, but he won several of them. In fact, he won the season-long Bridgestone Pole Award Championship last year with 8 pole positions. Paul Tracy, Junquera, Carpentier, and Ryan Hunter-Reay were the first 5 in the Bridgestone Pole Award standings. Our Bridgestone passion for excellence, Jan Vikas.
With Al Spire, there was a lot of talk on the radios about the alternate tires. These are some alternate tires from Sebastian Bourdais' car. Al, take a look at this, because some people said it was greasing up. What's the case of this tire?
Well, Sebastian's probably our poster boy here because he got the best wear out of his alternate tires. He actually set his fastest race lap on lap 28 just before he pitted about lap 30. So his held up fine, but the softer tires, John, they are going to go off a little bit more than the harder ones. And that's just something the drivers have to manage during their stint.
Show us what you're looking for. If we get tight here and we look, how can you tell whether he's the poster boy or not?
Well, there's actually little wear indicators here. You can see these holes, so there's wear left in this tire. And that's what we look at right away when the tires come in, and there's a nice wear pattern on this tire. So again, for Sebastian, the alternates work fine. And of course, the timing of the pit stop could have been better.
And as a matter of fact, we're going green. Thank you, Al. Back to racing.
Jimmy Vassar is the restart leader because he stopped early, Derek. Didn't have to stop on this cycle. He's in front of Tracy Bourdais and Andrew Ranger, but here comes Tracy.
Oh, Tracy on the inside. Now, what's going to be interesting here is Bourdais is on another set of reds. He is on the softer tires. Tracy is not. So if Bourdais is able to use those tires that efficiently, he could use this extra grip to really hound our leader, Paul Tracy.
Running order top left of your screen as Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. Riding with Sebastian Bourdais. Second spot, he nips by Jimmy Vassar, who has to settle into third in the PKV Gulfstream role.
It just shows you the total Vassar's in. He's light on fuel compared to Bourdais and Tracy, and yet he is no match even in the brake zones. But now Bourdais has cleared Vassar. He is on the faster Bridgestone Reds. He's going to run down Paul Tracy. This could be good.
Tracy Bourdais, Andrew Ranger next in line as we take a look at the 2004 series champion chasing the 03 title holder, Tracy. Tracy trying for the hat trick here in the streets of Long Beach. He's won the last 2 of these races.
He is spectacular here. And he's also the type of driver that Bourdais knows if you're going to try and make a move on Tracy, you better make it decisive. It's a bit like the old Mario and Reddy days. If you wanted to make a move on Mario, he would chop your nose off if you didn't absolutely take the position away from him.
Spirafico offline down into turn one, gives ground, slower car as we ride with Sebastian Bourdais. The Arena Football League on NBC. Coming up, the drive to Arena Bowl 19 in Las Vegas underway. Chicago hoping to defend its home turf against the Colorado Crush. Others will see Las Vegas against Philadelphia. The AFL is on NBC next Sunday at 1 Eastern, 10 Pacific.
Hey, boys, hang on to your hollyhocks because Bourdais is all over Paul Tracy.
Tracy and Bourdais will be back with more in Long Beach. Away from the streets of Long Beach, some wild action on the front straightaway. Sebastian Bourdais and Paul Tracy, Derek Daly, as you called it, wild action.
Brilliant in the brake zone is Bourdais. Goes down the inside. That was Paul Tracy's famous move. Tracy tries to come back, realizes he can't make it. On board. I'm sure he used push to pass. He's gaining. Down the inside. Boy, he flew by him, which was a surprise. Look at him grab a gear. Turns in. The rear reason he had to make hay and get by Tracy is if he's on the softer reds, he needs to get ahead and pull away and get advantage of these softer tires, because at the next stop, Bourdais goes on the slower, harder tires, and Tracy gets the faster reds.
We have one pit stop round left for these drivers today. 43 laps to go. Bourdais with the lead, Jan Beekes.
Guards to Sebastian Bourdais. Derek, you're exactly right. That's what they've told him on the radio. They have told him to stand on it. They're not giving him a fuel number. They know that this is the stint on the reds. They have to make hay, as you said. They're well aware of it. They're kind of cheerleading on the sidelines here in the pits. They know he has to build up a big gap. Remember, some drivers may not be able to use the reds. It's just that Sebastian's car works very well on them. So as long as it does, they're taking advantage of it.
Now Bourdais showing you why he's the defending series champion. Started fourth, he's come to first here, coming up on halfway. While we have a moment, visit the series website, champcarworldseries.com. Click on Race Director, you can get many different camera views. Watch the action online 24/7 at champcarworldseries.com, Race Director. Sebastian Bourdais looking off the nose of that Newman Haas number one, Derek Daly. He has taken advantage, exactly as you said, getting by Tracy. Tracy was holding him up, I think.
Yeah, stand on it. Nothing a driver loves more than the team to say, stand on it. Don't save fuel. Use the car. Use, but don't abuse, as Heather would term it. But the McDonald's car is absolutely flying. Associate sponsorship from Centrix Financial on this car and Bruno's car this weekend. Of course, Centrix pretty much owns the Denver Grand Prix. We'll be there later on.
Jimmy Vassar running third in car number 12. He is headed toward the PKV pits, the Gulfstream. Lola Janvikas.
He was hoping that he should have changed his strategy and come in when we got that other full course caution. Of course, when he pitted early, he was on an alternate strategy. Andrew Ranger in here at the same time. So for Jimmy Vassar, he knows this is going to drop him way back in the order. He goes with the standard tires, taking all the fuel. Andrew Ranger also 12.8, about the same length stop for Andrew Ranger. Both these guys now on the other strategy, it just is not going to play out. They will drop way, way back.
At the moment,
but everybody ahead of them is going to stop before them. They're going to have another 3 or 4 or 5 up window to try and make up some advantage on the racetrack. Look at him streak away. He is now on the last lap. He's now almost 3.5 seconds clear of Tracy. He is standing on it.
And of course, one thing that could come into play, if we have another full course yellow and you can save fuel, you can gain a lot of ground here, perhaps short fill on your last stop, run a lighter race car at the end of the event.
Absolutely. Interesting. When we listened to Paul Tracy's radio on that last stop, they were telling him, while they were giving him gas, they were telling him Bruno's come in at the same time. So he wanted that information on Bruno at that particular time because he couldn't see him. He was behind him. Well, now he's going to know what Tracy's trying to do. I wonder, does Paul Tracy have the speed to match him on the last stint when he goes on the softer Bridgestone Reds?
So Sebastian Bourdais is the leader. Tracy and Junqueira second, third. Dominguez fourth. Justin Wilson runs fifth.
So Dominguez still trying to run down Bruno Junqueira. They're holding station, but Bourdais is the man right now they're chasing.
Now, our Ford built for the race is being brought to you by Ford. 6 all-new vehicles, each of them built for the road ahead. 43 of 81 laps complete on the streets of Long Beach with Derek Daly, Ibrick Benjamin, Jan Beekes, and Calvin Fisher on pit road for us today. And we've got trouble for one of Dale Coyne's cars with 38 laps to go. This is Spirifico in car number 11. He had problems earlier. Derek was offline. This is on the front straightaway.
We believe it is a broken gearbox. Tony Cotman does not necessarily want to go full course yellow if he can avoid it. There it is right there. But they have somehow got to get that car down to a safety. No, it's got, you know
full
what,
course
full
yellow.
Course yellow.
Just that time by when Bourdais went by the start-finish line, the two yellow flags displayed by J.D. Wilbur. While we have a moment, let's take you through the field and show you where your favorite driver is running here today as we are under caution. Sebastian Bourdais, the race leader, took the lead. Different pit strategy. He's doubled up on the alternate red tires. He's trying to run away from Paul Tracy. He'd build a 5.5 second advantage in the McDonald's Newman Haas number one. But a lot of that's going to go away here under the full course caution. Second spot at the moment. We'll see him as he comes around to begin the run down the backstretch under yellow. As the safety car is out, there's Paul Tracy. former series champion, the Indec Forsyth number three, the 2003 champion. He's won two of these Long Beach Grand Prix in a row, gunning for three straight, and it would be five wins overall if Tracy can get back by Bourdais and close the deal. Third spot belongs to the Pacific Air number two of Bruno Junqueira. Junqueira, the series runner-up last 3 years, started on the outside pole, led early today, and is back in third. Mario Dominguez is fourth. He's making his first start for the Indec Forsyth team in car number seven. That's the car that Patrick Carpentier had driven in the past. Dominguez just got here and met his team for the first time this weekend. He runs fourth. And a quiet fifth so far is Justin Wilson in car number nine. That's the SanDisk car for the Roosport team, and that is your top five.
And running in sixth is young rookie Ronnie Bremer from Denmark. What a tremendous job he has done here this weekend. Really impressive in testing, just the one day, and the team said it was like he'd had a handful of days under his belt. They said he's unbelievable on cold tires. He cut his teeth here last year in the Toyota Atlantic Championship. Won at Denver, in fact, on the street, so he's very comfortable on this type of circuit, but he really cut his teeth back in Europe, running against the likes of Kimi Räikkönen, the Formula One star, in karts.
Alex Tagliani in the national colors of Australia. This is Team Australia. Aussie Vineyard sponsors this team. Tagliani, of course, run by Derek Walker. Tagliani, after the first day of practice, was just a big smile on his face, thinking how good a position he suddenly landed in. Right behind him is Timo Glock. Young German, 23 years of age. Jordan Formula One driver, our test driver last year, in fact, jumped in and did three races. One of the few F1 drivers, there he is right there in the Rocket Sports cars, one of the few F1 drivers that scored a world championship point on his debut in Formula One.
And for A.J. Allmendinger, he's been struggling this weekend. Derek, he likes a car that does not push. In other words, that when you turn the steering wheel, it has a lot of grip. And this particular track, it's hard to get it tuned in. The Roosport team's been working and working, but haven't quite found it. Because of that, in a moment, he's going to come on pit road and pick up some fuel.
Right behind him, Ryan Hunter-Reay. He is in the predominantly black and silver car. Black and silver car, Auto Beitel is the backer for this weekend. Of course, it is the second of the Rocket Sports cars. Ryan Hunter-Reay, very much one of the stars of the future, just dominated on the oval track in Milwaukee last year. Saw him win his first race in Australia, driving for Stefan Johansson's team. Lost time on Friday with fuel pressure problems. He's right ahead of D'Amato.
And he's the guy they call Shorty, back after a couple of years in Formula One. Cristiano D'Amato rides 11th, qualified 8th in the other PKV Lola. The other red and white, number 21. D'Amato unaccustomed to running that far back in front of Oriol Servian.
Servia's having a pretty strong run here today. They again started quite late. He's got a new engineer, Kyle Brannan, who worked in Toyota Atlantic last year, so he's got a lot to learn this weekend. And Servia said the car's running pretty good, but we're struggling over the bumps a little bit, which is really hurting his underbraking.
13th spot belongs to Bjorn Verdheim in the HVM number four. Very impressive all weekend, but has not raced very well here today. Marcus Marshall is 14th, Jimmy Vassar is 15th, and we're back underway.
Junqueira, you see Junqueira right behind Paul Tracy. Here he comes.
Here he goes, the outside.
Tracy makes it work hard, though. Comes down the inside. Not a block move, a defensive move. Didn't change his line. Made it difficult for Junqueira. Paul Tracy knew exactly what Junqueira was going to try and do there.
So now Bourdais gets his elbows up and hopes to build that lead once again. He's already opened up a couple more car lengths on Tracy.
Yes, he has. Softer tires make that a bit easier. You got to be mistake-free here. Dominguez doing a great job. Wilson still hanging on very well. Hasn't been a threat, but just been quick enough to hang on. Calvin?
Checked in with Neil Mickelright. He said we are very concerned about the pace of Bourdais with those red tires. This yellow has really helped us out enormously and cut that gap way back. So right now they're saying Tracy just needs to try and keep inside of him and we'll have the advantage for that final stint.
Reason the yellow helps is Bourdais was running away. Yellow comes out, they all close up. The worst thing that could happen to Bourdais right now is he's going to try and stretch his legs as another yellow comes out and wipes out a potential lead that he has built up.
A.J. Allmendinger has moved the Roosport car, the number 10, up into the top 10, up into ninth spot. He was the Roush-France Rookie of the Year in 2004, bright young American hope, racing now out of Denver, Colorado. Terrific young man, over Toyota Atlantic and Barber Dodge Pro Champion. The rookie standings last year from Roche, France. Allmendinger defeated Wilson at the final race of the season. Roberto Gonzalez was third. Our continuing look at A.J. Allmendinger behind the wheel here at Long Beach. Earlier, a couple of days ago, Calvin Fish sat down with the 2004 Rookie of the Year and asked him some questions.
What is your favorite sport to watch other than auto racing?
Football.
Favorite actor?
Paul Newman.
Favorite city?
Surfers Paradise, Australia.
Favorite vacation spot?
Haven't ever taken one.
Favorite TV show?
Seinfeld.
What sound do you like? What noise, what sound do you like?
My engine starting up while I'm sitting in the race car.
What profession would you like to attempt if it wasn't racing?
Nothing else, I'd be a bum on the street because I don't know how to do anything else.
If heaven exists, what do you want God to say as you arrive at the pearly gates?
That was the best race car driver ever.
And he's got high hopes indeed this season, Derek Daly.
I want to ask Calvin some of those questions.
I'm not sure we can put him on TV with the answers, though.
That was good. I enjoyed that piece.
We'll see a lot more of that all season long as Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. The Beijing logo's on the side of the Roush Sport 10 for Allmendinger. Up into ninth position, chasing Timo Glock right now. As we watch the lead battle, this is Tracy Junqueira third. Fourth spot to Dominguez. Fifth belongs to Justin Wilson. Ronnie Bremer has cycled up to sixth right now as they all chase Sebastian Bourdais. 33 laps remain here on the streets of Long Beach. We'll be right back with more on NBC. History last year for this man, Sebastian Bourdais, and the McDonald's number one. He is your race leader. Started fourth, has played his pit strategy perfectly. He has the lead, trying to build that advantage over Paul Tracy. March may be over, the madness only beginning. Coming up in May on NBC, the top 64 poker players in the world gather for a one-of-a-kind tournament. Johnny Chan, Doyle Brunson, and other great stars at the National Heads Up Poker Championship. Join us on NBC for that Sunday, May the 1st. I don't know about poker, Derek, but they're playing their hand pretty well, I think, in Bourdais' pit here.
Absolutely. He is absolutely flying. He is standing on the gas here. He is just driving the wheels off this thing. When you're on board, you can see him making corrections all over the place. His dad, Patrick, is here for this weekend to see how the season kicks off. Of course, his dad is also a professional race car driver, still races at the Le Mans 24-hour race, where Sebastian grew up. That's where he lives.
Looking to the inside, Justin Wilson had a thought, trying to get by Mario Dominguez to take over fourth as they came to turn one. That's Wilson in the SanDisk car. That's car number nine for the Roush Sport team. A couple of Carl Russo's entries. Take another look, Cristiano Domani on Mikas.
And he has been struggling this weekend. They add some more front wing to the car. Cristiano Domani had such high hopes that our testing program went fantastic. They just have not been able to find the grip for some reason here at Long Beach.
Our Lucas Oil helmet cam with Domani on the rev limiter up through pit road, Derek. It's got to be excruciating to have to wait so long on a long pit road to get up to speed.
It is. What's more excruciating for him is the speed of the car. I mean, you come back from F1 2 years with such high hopes. They moved Jim McGee over because Jim McGee is the most experienced and successful managers of this type of racing. It just hasn't clicked yet, but don't bother. You won't have to wait too long. They will get this together. He will start running fast.
Now, Domani stopped with 30 to go. That should carry him to the end, and he's the first to do. Is he rolling the dice on strategy?
Absolutely. That's the only thing he could do.
So Domani should be good to go to the end here, and perhaps this will play to his benefit. He restarts, though, in 16.
What he needs is a full course yellow, pack everybody up, send everybody to the pits. He's looking good.
Could so happen.
He's gambling for track position here.
We've had three full course cautions already today with 30 laps to go at Long Beach as we ride down the backstretch.
Look how bumpy this is on the way down the backstretch.
Sebastian Bourdais continues to lead, almost 4 seconds ahead of Paul Tracy. Junqueira third, another second and a half passed.
He is now just over 4 seconds clear of Tracy. The Bridgestone Reds are apparently actually worth about 0.3 of a second. It looks in race conditions that, in fact, Bourdais is even faster than that, just that 0.3 of a second.
Went straight away. How about full throttle? Let's take a lap with Sebastian. Benjamin, it's been a wild one so far, but it's been all Tracy and Bourdais.
It really has, and it's a bit of a surprise because Bourdais was only fourth in qualifying, and he didn't believe he had the speed to run with the Paul Tracy. As it happens, strategically, they've made a great move, but we don't know yet whether it pays off. Is he far enough ahead of Tracy before he goes on the slower Bridgestone tires? We don't know that yet.
Those Bridgestone Reds, the alternates, have paid off so far for Bourdais. This guy had a great opportunity Friday night. We're all pea green with envy, as they say. He got to visit the Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and there was another special guest in the house. Take a look at Friday night's action.
Made the best man win. Paul, do you have any advice or otherwise for your man here?
Pray for your life.
Jay, you got
Where did my high school buddies see this?
You got any life insurance?
Well, fine, I won't need it.
Okay, you only go on the green flag. Ready, go! Okay, who will win? Who will win? Will it be the gorgeous sex symbol with the light blue eyes? Or might it be Paul Newman? Paul Newman is leading. Now, that's turn two. This is the home stretch here, down past Access Hollywood. Newman's still Telemundo right here. This is the checkered flag right here. Okay. Paul Newman manages to win.
In fact, Jay Leno's agent called Derek, and Jay's going on vacation this summer. I think you might have a second gig here.
You know what? That might be something, but I'll probably have my agent turn it down.
You would think that's all fun. Leno practiced before Newman ever got there. Newman wanted private practice, not knowing Leno had already spent half an hour practicing. These boys went at it serious because Newman absolutely wanted to make sure he didn't get beaten by the non-professional race car driver.
Well, Jay Leno is truly a car guy. He's got a huge private collection, loves the sport.
Very much so, and to my surprise, I then went with Jay back to his warehouse where he's got more than 200 cars. He has, I think, almost 200 motorcycles. It was an unbelievable collection as Bourdais fights for control here, but an unbelievable collection that is like a museum. The beauty of Jay Leno and his car collection, he drives them.
Yeah.
He actually uses these cars on a regular basis out on the road. Really enjoys his car collection. Very fun.
Everything from modern equipment, a Ford GT, all the way to vintage machines.
Steam engine cars, race cars, McLaren Formula One, road car, the new Mercedes SLR. He's got everything. I love to see a man engage enjoy his passion like he can do and actually use them out on the public roads.
2003 Champ Car World Series champion Paul Tracy running second, 5.5 seconds now behind former champion, last year's champion, Sebastian Bourdais. Here comes Bruno Junqueira running third. These two started on the front row this afternoon. Junqueira there in the Pacific Care number two in third spot. One car on pit road, Calvin Fish.
Alex Taglialli brings the Team Australia Lola in. That's very significant. Walker Racing have been running Reynards for the past couple of years. And he's on standard tires, so he's going to be at a bit of a disadvantage here for the final stint. He's used up his reds early, but the team are very pleased with Alex Taglialli this weekend. He said the team is gelling very quickly. They have a lot of test days left in this series. They're going to be strong before this season's out, Rick.
As we watch Taglialli, who won his first career event 1 year ago, 2004 at Road America. Here's Bourdais continuing to work on building the lead. Now, Derek, 23 to go. Cristiano D'Amato in danger. He's just a couple of seconds away from being lapped here. D'Amato rolled the dice on that very early stop when the leaders, when Bourdais, Tracy, and Junqueira stop, they won't need anything close to a full fuel load.
No, they won't. But the real key will be, can Bourdais get in with enough of a gap, keep the lead on Paul Tracy, and give Paul Tracy an amount of work to do that'll be very difficult, despite the fact that Paul Tracy will be on the softer tires. But can you imagine Tracy on the faster, softer Bridgestone Reds, running, trying to pass Bourdais in the streets of Long Beach, which is his favorite racetrack?
Hang on to your hollyhocks.
Said it earlier.
It should be a dandy battle as we get down, coming up 20 to go. Now Bourdais made his last pit stop on lap 31, so he's 28 laps into this stint. He can probably go another three, maybe four laps. We understand that Newman Haas has put new tires out on pit road for Bruno Junqueira, so we should expect to see the two car on pit road shortly. That's D'Amato there in the PKV number 21, the Bell Micro car.
And the chances are Tracy is going to have to peel off earlier than Bourdais. He has done more laps in this stint than Bourdais by dint of the fact that he stopped earlier. So Bourdais has it going his way right now, everything including track position when he comes back out.
As we see Junqueira running third, dive to pit road, final stop of the day. He's headed your way, Anvikas.
And they
look
have
for Timmy, hit your mark.
Hitting the mark.
Approach.
Hitting the marks is important. They're going to put red labels on.
Stop. Nice and easy. Hit your mark. Foot on the brake.
John Tsitsonikas on the radio. It won't take all the fuel. Remember, he doesn't really care for these tires like his teammate.
Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Go, 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 go.
9.5 seconds. A nice quick stop. But remember, his car is not as comfortable as his teammate, who will be here next lap.
Bourdais and Tracy still 1-2. Tracy pitted two laps earlier than did Bourdais, Derek. So what does that mean as we get to this last stint of the race?
I don't know, but Tracy's tires and Bourdais' tires are out over the wall, so they could well end up coming in on the same lap here, which will give, then give Tracy the rest of this race to try and run Bourdais down on the softer tires. I don't know who to give the advantage to here, but it could be good.
This is Tracy. We'll see if he dives from pit road this time. Here he comes. Bourdais evidently has snow. He's on pit road as well.
Okay,
top two cars are on pit road. We're watching Paul Tracy.
You got to come around Mario's, guys.
Let's get it downstairs.
Paul Tracy brings it in. We expect the front tire pressure change. Red's going on. This is going to be critical here.
Start getting ready. Start getting ready. Wait.
At the very same time, we had a very quick stop for Sebastian Bourdais, and here comes Paul Tracy. He easily beats him out of pit road. A 10.5 second stop, everything routine, but remember, he is on the standard black sidewall Bridgestones.
And they're both on cold tires. Tracy is legendary for his speed on cold tires. He knows that. On this outlap, Tracy has to go like a scalded cat. He has to try and make up time on Bourdais. Oh, Bourdais gets stuck in traffic. Who that just went by? Is that Junqueira?
Could be. We will try to get a look and see who's up ahead there. Riding with Sebastian Bourdais, who had been the race leader. He'd had a 5 second lead build up on the softer tires. That was Ryan Hunter Ray, I believe.
Okay, so that will be a lapped car who will have to move out of the way. There's Tracy.
14.
It was 5.7 seconds when they went in. When they recycle around and go past the start-finish line, we will jump up on our monitor what the difference is. I wonder, can Tracy close it up on these cold tires on this outlap? Calvin?
Well, the key is going to be his teammate, Mario Dominguez. He had a very clean stop as well. They put a little bit more front wing into Mario's car. They said the car's handling well, just a little bit of push. We're trying to adjust to these Reds. In qualifying, at least, the Reds actually made the car to go to a bit of an understeer balance where the car wouldn't want to turn on the early laps. They try and compensate for that. Let's go down to Jan.
And I'm with Kevin Kalkoven. There's been a big announcement today for Champ Car in regards to Beijing. What's the good news?
Well, the good news is that we signed a memorandum of understanding with the Beijing authorities to hold a race in Beijing in 2006 at a location that's only a few minutes outside the center of Beijing. And we think it's going to be a tremendous success, both for the series and also for our sponsors in China.
Now, today, I know your Champ cars are not running how you want, but you had a great victory today. First woman to win a Toyota Atlantic race, Catherine Legg.
Right.
You must just be thrilled.
Yeah, I was. And I mean, she's a great story because when we acquired Cosworth, I found her literally sitting in the offices at a reception. I said, what are you doing here? And she says, I want to race in Atlantics. What? But she was so persuasive and so professional that we gave her a test, and the test worked out well. And then I said, well, if it's a good test, we'll give you a ride in an Atlantic car. And if you do well, we'll keep sponsoring you. Never for a moment did I think she would win. But she's a great driver. And it's a wonderful example of how determination and professionalism can get you drives.
And a good sponsor. Thank you.
Back on board, Sebastian Bourdais. Bourdais fourth after his pit stop with Paul Tracy. He came out with the lead. He's got about a 3.5-second advantage over Tracy right now, but they're in traffic. Ronnie Bremer has taken over the race lead in one of the HVM cars. Bremer in his rookie Champ Car start out of Toyota Atlantics. We just heard about Catherine Legg, who became the first woman to win an Atlantics race here this weekend a couple of hours ago. Here's Bremer, the HVM team. Now, they're on a completely different pit stop sequence other than the leaders, but it may play to their advantage. He's on the Bridgestone Reds, the red alternate Potenza tires, and here comes Bremer to pit road. So he'll give up the lead under green, Calvin Fish.
And we expect no changes on Ronnie Bremer's car. What a day for this young man. Imagine leading your very first Champ Car race. They're taking the Reds off, going to the standard tires, so we'll lose a little bit of pace here. But a great performance. The key for these young rookies is pulling out the physical stamina to get to the finish. 10.3 pit stop, a good clean run for the HVM team.
So Bremer up through the gears off of pit road with 17 laps to go in the Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach. We'll be back in a moment with more coverage of Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford after these messages and out traveling with an ADT Security NBC Sports update. Sights and sounds of Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford on NBC Sports today. 1996 Series champion Jimmy Vassar is your leader with 14 laps to go. But he is on a much different fuel and tire strategy from the rest of the teams. As we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, Derek Daly, no mandatory pit windows today. Stop when you need to. Vassar elected to stop very early. He and the second place car driven by rookie Andrew Ranger probably need a gas and go. They may give up 8 or 9 positions here when they finally come to pit road.
This is Andrew Ranger here as a Canadian. This guy is spectacular. I mean, he is the type of driver. He's a bit like Paul Tracy. A move the women and children back from the front of the grandstands whenever he appears. He is that type and that style of driver. I am so impressed with what he has done with that new team this weekend here.
That is the MyJack Tide ride for Andrew Ranger out of Toyota Atlantics. Jan Bikas.
They've been cheering for him down on pit road. In fact, they've told him to use the Cosworth push to pass to try and see if he can get by Vassar even briefly, because they know if you lead the race, you get one championship point. They know when they pit, they're going to drop out of the top five, most likely, but they're really wanting him to be racy, and they are very, very impressed with this young man in his first ever race.
But please, Andrew, drive around him, not drive over him. I mean, look, he is just sliding his car around. Oh, Jimmy knows he's under pressure, too. He locks up that right front. That's the lightly loaded inside wheel. When you begin to turn right, the inside wheel is lightly loaded. They can lock up. But Ranger beginning to put him under pressure here. This is Eric Batchelar's team. Eric's son, Elliot, is a go-kart racer, is not here this weekend because he's racing in Indy.
He's racing with many fine young drivers who we'll be hearing more from in the years to come.
Drivers of the future.
Vassar down the front straightaway. The PKB team has set new tires out for Jimmy, but he elects not to stop that time by. 12 laps to go here in the streets of Long Beach. Vassar, Ranger, and Sebastian Bourdais up to third now. Bourdais about 5.5 seconds behind Ranger, 7 seconds behind Vassar. And remember, Vassar and Ranger on very light fuel loads compared to what Bourdais, Tracy, Dominguez, and Junqueira have now.
Ranger's going on the reds, so now he's potentially going to be even faster. Vassar right behind him.
Why wouldn't you roll the dice and go splash and go? No tires there.
Well, they will if they think he's going to be faster on these new reds, then they'll pull that on for him, yeah?
Well, we have the two cars together, both Vassar and Ranger, and Jimmy Vassar is going to do exactly what you said, Rick, no tires. They're just going to throw some fuel at it because we're so close to the end of the race. So we have two teams pitted right next to each other, one with the strategy for new tires, the other team for Jimmy, just a splash and go.
Vassar the leader, Ranger is second, Bourdais, Tracy, Dominguez. Bourdais got, what, 6-7 seconds over Tracy, who must have gotten hung up in traffic.
Yeah, Tracy has been nowhere near as fast.
Copy.
After this pit stop.
Top two cars are on pit road. They're headed to you, Jan.
And as I mentioned, there'll be no tires for Jimmy Vassar. They're just going to get just the amount of fuel he needs to get to the end of the event. So it's all down to the fueler in this case. And we will watch over our shoulder also as Andrew Ranger pitting at the same time, but he's taking tires. Well, the strategy worked. Jimmy Vassar is well underway, and they're still pushing the tire. Whoa! I tell you, when they get that thing on the rev limiter, you can feel the concussions down here on pit road.
Brings the Tide My Jack car off the jacks and I'm heading up pit road behind Vassar. Bourdais takes the lead back.
Question before the race, would Ranger be physically fit enough to drive this thing? It's a heavy car, it's a very hot day. Long Beach is very physically demanding. He's 18 years old, he looks 14. He's driven Atlantic cars, so from what I can see so far, he is physically well able for the task at hand here. Great job by Andrew Ranger. Calvin?
Here with Neil Micklewright, GM at Forsyth, and you thought you'd have the edge here in this final stint with the reds, but the lap times aren't showing that right now. Is it just traffic, or is Paul struggling with the car a little bit?
I think they're struggling with the car a little bit. I mean, obviously, and we've got some decent tyres on it, but I think the track's gotten a little bit slick. So right now, it doesn't look like we've got a good enough car to beat Bourdais, but still 10 laps to go, so we'll keep trying.
Long way to go. A yellow would certainly help them out if they could bunch them back up again, Rick.
Certainly would. Bourdais has retaken the lead, but there is trouble on the racetrack.
Oh,
Ranger has put the 27 car into the tire barriers. So on cold tires, just after that pit stop, fuel load taken, brand new Bridgestone Potenza Reds. Ranger lost it. Have a look at what happened. Oh, he had contact.
He got drop kicked by one of the HVM cars and just buried into the tire wall. What a shame for Andrew Ranger. It does cause a full course yellow.
And that will bunch the field up for the restart. Fourth full course yellow of the day. Jan Bikas, this doesn't help Sebastian Bourdais' cause.
No, it doesn't. I know you didn't want to see a yellow Craig Hampson, but the car looks just perfect.
Yeah, we really kind of struggled all through practice and qualifying. We were fairly quick in practice, but in qualifying, we just couldn't get the balance and get the speed and get the car consistent enough. It looks like it's really good now, but yeah, I did not want that yellow at all. Without it, we were solid. Now Tracy's got a shot at us. We've seen him pass a, you know, he's had a heck of a career on restarts and things like that. Let's say that. So Sebastian's just going to need to have a really good restart here, make sure he pulls a lead on him, and well, maybe there'll be a car or two in between us. That would help too. So.
Do you have power to pass time left for Sebastian to use as a defensive move?
Yes, yeah, we do have some push to pass left. Just got to be careful of PT. That's about all I could say.
Just remember, your teammate got beat by him before by not using it. You might want to consider that one.
Well, the race is almost over, so there's no point in having any leftover at the end. So
I figured you say that. Thanks.
All right.
Okay, the advantage Bourdais has, he has 24 seconds. That is more than enough. Tracy only has 8 seconds. Tracy has one more square to the juice. After that, he's done.
All right, we will see how it plays out. 9 laps remain. Back with more, Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford at Long Beach. After these messages and a word from our local NBC stations. powering through the streets of Long Beach with Derek Daly, Eirik Benjamin, Jan Beekhuis, and Calvin Fish on pit road. Round one of the 2005 Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. Safety car remains on the course with eight laps to go after Andrew Ranger got tapped coming into turn seven. His MyJack machine sliding into the tires did some suspension damage. Looks as though Ranger done for the day. The Newman-Haas Brain Trust considering things. Their driver Sebastian Bourdais will be the restart leader, but he'll have Paul Tracy on his rear wing, Calvin Fish, because they're going to move the lap traffic out of the way. And we'll hear from Calvin Fish in just a couple of moments. Here comes Del Monte onto pit road, along with Nelson Philippe off pit road, actually. Philippe's car, the 34, the white and red MyJack car, damaged earlier. They had to put a new nose wing on that race car. All right, Calvin Fish, what does Paul Tracy need to do here?
Well, he needs to get the jump on Sebastian, I feel, at the start. That's going to be critical. Sebastian, even though he's on the other tire, seems to have the edge right now in this final stint. I spoke to Neil Michelright. He does have some of that Cosworth power to pass left. I spoke to his teammate, Mauro Dominguez, Mike Pulowski, who's his crew chief. I said, does he have any left? He said, we are tapped out. All he has right now is a lot of ambition.
And that can be enough. Look at the numbers, Derek Daly. Sebastian Bourdais, 24 seconds of Cosworth power to pass. Tracy only eight.
Which is also an indication of how good Sebastian Bourdais' car has been. He hasn't needed to pet the extra 50 horsepower. But Marcus Marshall in the Team Australia car is between Bourdais and Tracy. If I was him, I'd wave Tracy by because, I mean, you could just get stomped on so easily here.
We were expecting to see Marshall ask to move over and allow the elite lap cars to have clear racetrack. We're hearing that perhaps he'll go to pit road this time by. You can see Tracy sneaking a look inside as they come down the backstretch, thinking he needs to jump around Marshall very quickly. When they come to the stripe, lights are out on the safety car, looking for a restart. There'll be just six laps to go, about 12 miles to settle it here in the streets of Long Beach.
I wouldn't bet against Tracy, but I don't think he has the speed, and Bourdais now has done this so many times, he understands what these restarts are all about. He's already pulled a couple of lengths here. Marshall is in Tracy's way.
Marshall's headed to pit road.
Green. Yeah.
Six to go as they come to the stripe. Bourdais jumps to a significant lead. Not on power to pass.
Doesn't even use it.
Junqueira down the inside of Dominguez.
Third spot, Dominguez tries to come back at him.
Wow, a Tracy type of move. You don't often see Junqueira do that in the opening laps. Great, great move, though, to put Newman-Haas's cars first and third as we speak.
Tracy runs second. That drops Dominguez back to fourth. Fifth belongs to Justin Wilson, who's quietly hung around the top five all day. Timo Glock sixth, Ronnie Bremer seventh, AJ Allmendinger eighth, Alex Tagliani ninth, Jimmy Vassar, who led with 14 to go. He's back in 10th after an early stop.
Justin Wilson in that SanDisk car really has had a great race. No mistakes. He stayed where he needs to stay. Wasn't quick enough to run with the leader. There he is right there ahead of his teammates. But he has run very well.
Down the back stretch. Into turn nine, riding with Wilson through the left-hand sweeper that takes you to the hairpin, puts you back onto the front straightaway. There'll be five laps to go this time by. Crossing his hands.
Notice the way, yeah, different driving style. Crosses his hands completely over, as opposed to Bourdais, who puts both hands at the bottom and then winds the wheel around at the hairpin.
Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. We'll be back on NBC. Three laps to go through the streets of Long Beach with Derek Daly, Eirik Benjamin, Jan Beekhuis, and Calvin Fish have been on pit road all afternoon. And Sebastian Bourdais from fourth to first, Derek Daly. He's got almost 3 seconds on Paul Tracy. Calvin Fish, Bourdais's got everything going his way.
He does. It looks smooth sailing out front, but Mauro Dominguez is really struggling. We saw him get jumped there on the restart by Bruno Junqueira, and recently Justin Wilson has got around and pushed him back to fifth spot. He's really a sitting duck. We talked about the fact that he had no Cosworth power to pass left in his tank, so to speak, so he's just been sitting in there on the straightaways. Those other guys have 50 more horsepower, and Justin Wilson, well, he has the most experience of anyone with using that situation. When he won the Palmer Audi series over in Europe, they had a similar technique to give the guys a little extra boost during the race.
Justin Wilson can be plenty proud. Just before we went away to commercial, Wilson snuck by Dominguez and took over fourth. Here's Junqueira, bottom of your screen, in front of Wilson, third and fourth. Now here's Dominguez back in fifth. He's got his hands full with rookie Timo Glock with two to go.
Last two laps, the two fastest men on the racetrack, Bourdais and Junqueira.
Justin Wilson in that SanDisk car. So Justin Wilson closing now on Bruno Junqueira, but I don't know. There he is right there. Look at Wilson now closing up right behind him.
This is for third.
He's looking good here, Wilson is.
Bourdais with a 3-second lead over Paul Tracy. They'll see the white flag next time by. Champ Car World Series moves to Monterrey, Mexico, third week of May.
You see Wilson just balanced his car all through. Through the corners, the car slides, he balances, he gets on the power, turns it in, balances it again.
What makes these so entertaining race cars, Derek, is you can drive them with the throttle at times.
Absolutely, you can. Yes, you can.
Bourdais coming to the white flag. One lap to go for the 2004 Series champion.
There's second place Tracy. There's Junqueira Wilson. So in the break zone is where Wilson has looked very good over the last 3 to 5 laps. Can he close up here?
Battling for third, here's Wilson. He's moved the SanDisk number 9 to fourth spot. He's still about 5 car lengths behind Bruno Junqueira.
Realistically, the back straight is the opportunity, probably the only one left. But he's going to be quick through here on the next left and right-handers. He's not close enough. He is not close enough.
You've got to be able to get off the corner better than the guy in front of you to make a move, especially on a slick, slick street course like this.
And on the last lap, Wilson again was the fastest car on the racetrack, even faster than Bourdais and Tracy.
To the back straightaway, final time around the streets of Long Beach. Sebastian Bourdais, 7 wins in 2004 on his way to his first Champ Car championship. Bourdais about to open 2005 with a drive from outside row 2. Started fourth this afternoon. Coming to the stripe, J.D. Wilmer waves the checkered flag over Sebastian Bourdais, the winner of the Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach. Paul Tracy checkers in second spot.
We'll need that when we get to Monterey.
Bruno Junqueira gets third. Justin Wilson comes home fourth. Mario Dominguez fifth. Rookies Timo Glock and Ronnie Bremer finish sixth and seventh. There's Tracy alongside Bourdais. They congratulate each other. A.J. Allmendinger comes home in eighth spot for Roush Sport. Jimmy Vassar is ninth. Cristiano D'Amata 10th. Oriel Servia, Bjorn Wertheim, Ryan Hunter Ray, Alex Tagliani, Marcus Marshall, Del Monte, Ranger, Philippe Fitzmurphy. We had 11 lead changes among 8 drivers today. Now the series takes a break for 6 weeks while we have a timeout. Bourdais is about to serve up some donuts here to the fans. Third week of May, we'll move from Long Beach to Monterrey, Mexico. Great battle there 1 year ago. Jimmy Vassar was involved with Alex Tagliani. Some side-by-side involving Paul Tracy. But at the end of the day, it was Sebastian Bourdais bagging his first win of the season on his way to a championship. It's the Tecate Telmex Grand Prix of Monterrey on the 22nd of May on Speed Channel. Check your local listings. Donuts from Sebastian on the menu at McDonald's tomorrow.
You know what? They look pretty good. Yeah, those donuts are okay.
He had a lot of practice last year.
Yeah, the French guys can do croissants at times, but they've had a bit of practice. They're not great, but they are okay. But what a great performance he has had this afternoon. Just awesome.
And the Newman Haas team extends their run of dominance in the Bridgestone presents the Champ Car World Series powered by Ford. So Bourdais wins the opener in 2005. On his way, perhaps, to back-to-back titles, we shall see. But Tracy, Junqueira, Wilson and Dominguez will be among the drivers nipping at his heels throughout the season. And a great rookie run for Timo Glock.
It really was. We didn't see him quite feature why we thought he would all through the race, but to come home sixth in his first race, to run as well as he did in practice and qualifying, they will leave with that Rocket Sports team very, very pleased. I will bet they will taste champagne before too long this season.
Rookie Ronnie Bremer comes home seventh for the HVM team, so Bjorn Wertheim must have been the car that was involved with Andrew Ranger. There's A.J. Allmendinger. He got up to eighth in front of Vassar and D'Amata. Servia. There's Ryan Hunter Ray back in 13th. Marshall gets 14th. Tagliani struggled late in the day. Del Monte, Ranger, Nelson Philippe, 18th, 19th to Ricardo Spearfico.
And only 2 cars out of this opening race of the season.
Very durable. Heading take the victory lane, Sebastian Bourdais, the winner of the season opener, the Toyota Grand Prix of Long Beach. 31st annual running of this great event. Huge crowds all weekend long. Well, more than 100,000 fans here today, and they watched the virtuoso performance by Sebastian Bourdais.
Well,
for Jan Beekes, Calvin Fish, and Derek Daly, we thank you for joining us today. I'm Rick Benjamin. Be sure and stay tuned for your local news, except on the West Coast. You've been watching Bridgestone Presents the Champ Car World Series, powered by Ford, on NBC Sports. We'll talk to you next time.
Yeah! So give my best.